Hello, everybody. I've been working in my shop today, kind of getting it made my mind here. I put me some signs up, been cleaning on it, because we got done with my little Suzuki I was working on from the previous video and waiting on some parts, but check it out. Got me some signs up here. Got a Shell, and got me a little Texaco motor oil. Full service garage. Open when I feel like it. My garage, my rules. Guys, pardon this train coming by. They're fixing to make us dead. One of the things about working in a building where it's cheap. Then I got the castor oil motor oil sign over here. I gotta pull the plastic off of it though. And I got one over here, but I gotta block out a word on it because of YouTube. Yeah, don't touch mine. Warning. Kind of funny there, guys. But over here, guys, I've got my GM performance parts. Used to be a clock, and it will be one of these days when I find one to go in it. I love it though, because it's Chevrolet, General Motors, and I had to put it next to my General Motors sign. Oh, here I got Champion. Now, here's that train. Just give it a minute. Got my hangers on the wall. I think these were for belts from back in the day. They were actually hanging on the wall over there on the far side of my shop where my office is. And I took them down and put them on the walls there. And over there, you saw one. I got my alignment machine. I mean, alignment machine. I wish. Tire balancer. I wish. No, guys, this is a wheel brake lathe. Now, it's old, but it works good. It's done made me money. My landlord's supposed to have this out of my building. It's an old tire spreader, but I have absolutely no need for it. It's in my way. I got this little small block Chevy down here that I'm fixing to overhaul. Waiting to get my engine stand and get it on there. I'm going to do a video of doing that, of tear down and put together. Yeah, I got to get this back to the house. This is my canopy we used outside when it was hot, hot. So I do work on my side too, guys. I ain't scared. We get it done. Now, I want to show you guys something in the world out there. You see this tool here? This one right here. This is called an underhood creeper. Now, for anybody out there who knows what this is, y'all know what I got, something's good. This is for working on trucks, diesels, gas, later model vehicles. You put it up there, and I'm going to tell you, man, you can literally get up on it. See how that works? You can work on the engine. But, yeah. Man, got all my tools here that I bought over the years. My wife knew how much this stuff right here cost. Woo. Yeah, what this is specialty tools, a little bit of everything here. Had to buy me a shelf to put it on to get out of my toolbox because, you know, I got a lot of toolboxes, but they're pretty full. I mean, I'll show you my first box that I got. This is my big box. Snap-on, it is. But it's the 80th anniversary edition, and I just fell in love with it. Look at the mural on it. That's actually an old socket set. You see that? Yeah. I bought this one for $1,500. It's cheap. It's an older box, though. I mean, and I had this one first, and actually, yeah, I think it's the same generation of this one, or close, in my big box. And that was my roll-around forever until I purchased this one to retire that one. And this one here, I use a pee out of it with that and this. This is my setup. This is just my main that I use all the time. I mean, I ain't joking, though. Let me show y'all. And yeah, my tools are not organized because it just can't happen. My organization is in that car. See, I'm all my electrics down there. See, this is... See, I have some tools. I'm not even opening up these boxes. I mean, down here is specialty stuff and tools. My torque wrenches, and I got some old rings and stuff. And I got a little room and a few of these over here. There's stuff's gonna go in it. I got my torques in here. Here's my half-inch drive drawer. It's pretty full. I need to get me some deals to put these sockets on and make it better. I don't have any of those yet. This is just a catch-all. I put nuts and bolts and what have you in here. Just everything. You never know. I mean, I got everything in here from battery cable clamp, radiator cap. You just never know. This is a piece for a 3.8 liter Chevrolet V6. And then here's my electrical drawer. You think I got to do a solder or anything? It's in this drawer. Wiring drawer. Electronics. And this is just kind of a drawer. It's got a little bit of everything in it. I mean, I use all kinds of stuff in here. There's a lot of stuff. Then my big box over here. You see, it's just kind of random stuff. And this drawer here is my drill bits and what have you. Just more random stuff. Fuse drawer. This is my AC drawer. In here, I've got AC O-rings, fittings, you name it, AC stuff. Quick disconnect fittings. This is pretty much the drawer for any line you can take off. This drawer will do it. More electrical stuff. This is my meter drawer. Electrical stuff. Power probe drawer. That's the best tool in the world for electronics and cars. Kind of some more electrical stuff down here too. A short finder. Over here in this side box, I've got some electronics and stuff in it, but nothing really to speak of. Some bolts and nuts. I don't use it too much just for storage. This drawer up here, it's kind of like storage too, but my stuff that I don't want to get broke, anything like that goes in this drawer. I mean, you know, my calipers, you know, light bulbs, just, you know. This is kind of like miscellaneous sockets and stuff, and, you know, it's just, I'm going to try to plan on getting all this there separated out. And miscellaneous wrenches in this drawer. You know, it's a little bit of, a lot of wrenches in here that I've made for stuff over the years, like this one. That's a homemade wrench I've made for something. This is for ejector lines on diesels. You see how I ground it down to make it fit? There's a bunch of stuff like that in here. I can show you some. There's a wrench that I made for something. There's another one. Actually, this is for a diesel. Yeah. Most of these wrenches I made are for diesels. I have a lot of tools that I made for diesels. I'll show them to you. Yeah. Yeah, this drawer here has got compression gauges, timing light, engine building drawer here. Down here is my relay tester kit. And over here, I supposed to have a tool that was over there on that shelf that I put over there. I made room. What I was trying to do. This is files, sorted pliers, just, you know, but mainly files is in this drawer. This is my chisels. Actually, these files here are supposed to have been down there. I didn't realize that. My plastic, this is supposed to be up there. See, this is for my move, guys. Everything got all destroyed. These are my little screwdrivers and torques. I got a couple of things that went here that's over there now. See, these are stud extractors. This is my air blower, which is actually over there. And this is my battery service kit, which the rest of this is over there, my roll around, because I use it all the time. This is my air hammer drawer. Heat gun drawer and some pullers and stuff. My other pullers is over there. No place to put these. Drill bit set, tap and die set. That's what this drawer's for. And this down here is my grease gun and just my grinder. Just kind of a little bit of pullers. Oil pump, probably for small block Chevy. Yeah, let me show you some of these tools that I've made for diesels. This here's for Cummins. It's down here. Yeah. Right there it is. See this? That's for Cummins. I made that. And it works. You know, the tool they make, the tool they sell you to do this is like $600. Yeah. I'm not going to tell you what I made it for, but it's working on a Cummins. You guys out there that work on Cummins will know what that's for. It has to do with something on top of a cylinder head. That's all I'm going to say. Yeah, I got all kinds of stuff up here that I have to go through. There's some good parts up here. There's some junk. Got a bunch of nuts and bolts. Like I said, from the move, man, everything kind of just kind of got scattered around. Got my little jack down there for doing transmissions and my little 110 welder wire. And got a 110 stick, which works good. Vacuum pump for AC. My press. It's only a 12-ton, but it'll work. Got to have something first. Yeah, I got a compressor over here that my nephew gave me. That is crazy, man. This is a screw compressor. Man, these units here, these pumps right here are $1,200 a piece. They sure are. But it's got a capacitor blow, one of these things over here on that side. Won't let it work. We were going to use this because he told me I could use this because this thing here supplies a lot of air, but it don't work. And I went ahead and just bought me a new compressor. Let me show you what I got in here. This is my compressor room. I like this because it keeps my compressor quiet. It ain't loud. I bought this new compressor to put it in here. And I plumbed it in to this great big old monster tank. So I have two big huge tanks full of air. I have plenty of air. I'm going to do paint and body work and all kinds of stuff. This is my little catch room, though. I just got stuff stored in here. Just I don't need this stuff in my shop. It's just in my way. My tires from my old GMC. Yeah. My old GMC over here is actually a pretty cool old truck. The bumper on this thing is cool because over there is Rustin's Concrete. Okay. Well, my bumper on my truck says Rustin's GMC Trucks right there. Darien, Oklahoma. Well, Rustin's, the same ones over there, they had a dealership years ago. And apparently I sold this truck. This here's a little minivan that I've got on a deal. Customer did some work for them and they couldn't pay me, so they gave me this van. It's honestly junk. The motor's blowed up in it, but I can scrap and get my money she owes me on it. But that's basically it. This is my shop. We wait on a customer, waiting on parts for this one. They're supposed to be here sometime today, hopefully. Hopefully. But, you know, this is my shop. This is what we're doing today. Nothing right now because we're slow. It's, you know, it's the end of the month. Yeah. Got to do some cleaning and rearranging still. Yeah, this whole thing here, I got to put all this stuff away. It's kind of got messed up and there's stuff everywhere. But, you know, all in due time. Pretty good for a man, though, who just started. All he had was these toolboxes right here. Is all I had when I came here. I got a tire machine, brake lathe, welders. All this is my stuff, and I've accumulated since I got here. Well, God bless you guys. Peace out and pray for us. With this time and age and everything going on in the world, we need all the help we can get. Later and peace out.